This would be more of like a walk pirouette. This would be something where you're maintaining forward motion as you're making that turn. So instead of being a turn on the hindquarters, it's almost like you keep the hind end by the cone and you make the turn, keeping the hindquarters closer to the cone than the front end is. And then I'm going to come to the next cone, and I'm just going to bump my horse off my leg because he's not forward enough. And then I'm going to do my walk pirouette here. Keep the hindquarters by the cone. And then off to my next cone. Let's try this one again. And I just offered it there. That was much better. I did not have to bump him. And you've got to throw those things in, right? So like these exercises, you're going to have little teachable moments. There, he didn't keep his hind end quite as good. So I'm going to ask for a couple more steps. And then we're lined up for this cone. And now I'm going to show you a walking turn on the forehand. But find little areas where maybe your horse is a little sticky. I'm going to keep his front end kind of by the cone and move the hind end around. I'm just going to pick this cone here because we ended up facing it. And then I'm going to move the hind end around. Now I'm going to have a plan and look in advance. And we'll walk to this cone. And he's much better off my leg now. So it was worth taking that moment, bumping him up, getting him off my leg. And now we're talking. Now we're in a position where he's not. We're going to send him forward a little here. Good. Where he's not resistant to my leg. He's much softer and more forward off the leg. So that's this exercise. You've got a lot of variations you can play around with. As I'm giving you a lot to do here. When you grab your audio lesson, we're going to talk mostly to the circle and the preparation for the circle, but then you can modify it when you're listening to the audio, and you can decide if you and your horse would like to take it to the next level and try it with some turns on the forehand, turns on the hindquarters. Make use of those teachable moments. So when you have times where your horse is not quite getting it or they're making a mistake, it's okay. Don't get upset, but think about how you could use that moment to create a learning opportunity for both you and your horse. And you might have to do it a few times. If he hadn't been light off my leg after I bumped him up, I probably would have done it a time or two. It's a lot of times much easier to get the conversation just over with and get a good change from your horse rather than sitting there and nagging them and nagging them and nagging them. So sometimes if they're not getting it, and it's something that they know. So there's a difference when they don't know, because when they don't know, they just don't know. But if they know something and you're used to a certain type of response and feel from them, it's really important that if they're not paying attention and they're not listening, then you go ahead, you use that as a moment to make that point and say, hey, this is my feel, this is what I expect. And then when they do what they're asked, you leave them alone, you stay nice and soft, and you harmonize with them. Now, I'd like to clarify just a little bit in regards to when they don't know. When they don't know, what I try to do is I try to think of, like, what other things can I do to help clarify and explain this to my horse so that they understand it better. I might have to do a completely different exercise. I might have to slow down, take things back a notch, and then we can progress forward from there. So there's a difference in the two, and just understand that when you're thinking about this. Okay, until next time, happy riding.